The question is asking to draw out all constitutional isomers for C4H10, since this chemical formula fits in the general formula of CnH2n+2, that means it's an alkane. Let's start by drawing a 4-carbon chain, 4 carbons connected straight in a row like this. We know that carbon can make 4 bonds, and since the first carbon is already connected to 1 carbon, that means it will connect to 3 hydrogens. The second carbon is already connected to 2 carbons on the left and right, so that means it has a remaining of 4 minus 2 equals 2 bonds. The third carbon is the same as the second carbon, so it will also have 2 bonds. The last carbon only connected to 1 carbon like our first carbon, so therefore 4 minus 1 equals 3 bonds. Now we put in all the hydrogens and we have our first structure of C4H10. Since there's no other way to draw 4 carbon chain, our next isomer will be 3 carbon long. Place in the remaining carbon on the second carbon, like this. Now, what if we place the remaining carbon at the end like this? Is this another isomer? Well, actually it's not. We've already drawn this guy, look. It has 4 carbon connected straight in a row. So back to our 3 carbon chain. Let's fill in the rest of the bonds. The first carbon is connected to only 1 carbon, so it has 3 bonds. The second carbon is already connected to 3 other carbons, so only left 1 bond. Third one is the same as the first one, so 3 bonds. And this substituent, the guy, the carbon, hanging there, it's also connected to 1 carbon, so that means it has 3 remaining bonds as well. Now we fill in with hydrogens, and we have our second and final structure for C4H10. These are the two isomers we've drawn for C4H10. Well, we can't draw any more isomers for C4H10 because if we were to start with 2 carbon chain like this, and then we have 2 extra carbons, right? So if I place 1 carbon on each of the carbons like this, in reality, it is the same as our first isomer because you can count 4 carbons straight in a row like this. And also, if we were to start with 2 carbon chain, and then we place the remaining carbons on the first carbon, essentially it's the same as our second isomer because we actually have a 3-carbon chain with 1 carbon substituent on carbon number 2. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.